leaving our overnight moorings, waiting for the Anderton boat lift. Just going up now to the mooring spot. You have to arrive half an hour early for safety briefing. So we're moored up outside the Anderton boat lift, ready to make the 50-foot descent down onto the River Weaver. There's a boat just come up the lift, just coming out of the entranceway now. Coming out of there at a bit of a lick, actually. That one's come out of there and overdone it a bit. It's got to do a bit of reversing. Comes the chap to give us a safety briefing, I think.
Hello there.
Hello.
Hello. Hi. Are you down as well?
Yes.
Yep.
Have you been through before?
No.
Okay. It doesn't matter whether you have or haven't, but I have to give you a little safety talk to start with, okay? So he's going to go in. He's going to go in first.
Yeah.
We're both going in together.
Yeah.
Okay, so he's going to go in and he's going to position his boat, hopefully on the downwind side on the aqueduct.
Right.
The gate. So once he's gone in there and he's clear, then if you just follow him in, but you'll be going alongside him like you would in the lock.
Yeah.
Okay. And the main thing is that your stern is clear of the gate and I'll just bring it down.
Right.
Okay, so I'll make sure that's the case anyway. Okay. When we're in there, I need someone on the tiller at all times.
Yeah.
Okay, for the whole duration of your time in there. If you need to go front to aft, then through the cabin. No going over the top, no going along the side, no reaching out to take great photos or anything like that, okay? So please stay within the footprint of your boat, all right? I've had people, you know, they've gone through with friends and they've swapped boats and done all sorts
of
stuff.
Oh my word.
So please, none of that.
No, I will be very young.
So as soon as he's gone, please follow him.
Okay.
Have you got any questions at all for me?
One question, you say one person on the tiller all the time. Do you need me to have the engine going then?
When you get onto the aqueduct, you don't need to tie up at that point. You just need to keep your engine running.
Right.
Okay, so just hold station.
Okay.
Because once I get the gate closed, I'm going to lift another set of gates and I'm going to call you in both in together.
I see, okay.
So when we get to that point, I'll give you some more instructions.
All right.
It's better not to give you like
overload.
Yes, yes,
absolutely.
Yes,
so
yes.
How many on board in total?
That's
any
it.
Any pets or anything?
No.
Okay.
Thank you.
Thank you.
What's your name?
Jim.
Thank you, Jim.
give you both the thumbs up, coming together now. Right, I'll stand at a point where there's a hook on the side, on each side. When you get to that hook, you need to put a stern rope around the hook, back onto your boat and tie off. When you're both tied off, then you can stop your engines. Okay, and then that's all you need to worry about.
Have you done it before?
No.
That's not the point.
No.
You're not enjoying it.
Yeah, I can tell you all sorts of stories about Sue and heights.
Oh, you must say you don't look that
now is we've drained the water from between the two gates. Okay, so we keep it, the gate obviously has to keep the water in the aqueduct, and the gate that's nearest you keeps your water in the gate hole. And then you'll move ever so slowly down until that latch clears that hook. See the two, there's a latch going on the top of the hook?
Yeah. Yeah.
So they'll slowly move apart. So the latch will move towards you. So once that's clear, I guess say, are you clear? And then I'll say yes or no. So you won't be able to see anything for it's almost infinitesimally slow.
Right.
Once I can hear the pumps have come on now, the hydraulics.
Yes.
So I know that at the moment they're just going to start lowering you slowly. Once those two things are cleared and starts to go a bit quicker, for the first metre or 2 metres you'll feel a bounce.
Right.
And nothing to worry about, it's been there since April. And it's to do with some sort of imbalance in the hydraulics. It's not a safety thing, it's just unfortunately just creates a little bit of damage. And that disappears, and it reappears again just as we get towards the bottom.
Right. Glad you've told me that.
Okay. That's the most exciting thing that's happened this month.
Be my stomach at the moment.
honestly, it takes about 6 minutes to do the step, so it's not very, very fast.
Oh, yeah, that's just engaged.
Yeah, that's we're moving now.
Yeah.
Feel it bouncing.
Yes, I can.
It will go. About this distance again, and it will.
Thank you. So now we're down on the River Weaver after descending the Anderton Boat Lift. A lot of industry down here. Just illustrates how that section of the Trent and Mersey Canal is built high up, and on the banks, as you, if you walk the towpath, you can look down, you can see your way above the surrounding countryside for quite an extensive length of it. Wide and completely overgrown on the banks. Well, Northwich is a really quirky little town, and it's extremely interesting. The timber frame buildings here, and it was done because the area was subject to lots of subsidence due to the salt works where they used to extract salt, and then cause big problems with subsidence. Going to show you around now and hope you enjoy what you see. It's good. Secure riverside moorings at Northwich, right next to the Odeon cinema. An entrance with a British canal and river trust. Okay. All very good. On floating pontoon. Nice old building. Notice the figurines up in the gable there. Wow, that's a salty dog. The fantastic figurines up on the gable. Well, there was a time when that was called the Beehive Inn, and it's now an estate agent's. Ah, the Swinging Witch Pub. Like so many high streets you walk up and down these days, there's plenty of retail outlets that are empty, derelict, up for rent. And forlorn. Nice little town this though. It's also a fact that charity shops that are allowed to work on reduced overheads are thriving. That's a beautiful old timber frame building, ornate carving on it. A traditional butcher's with sawdust on the floor, just like they used to years and years and years and years ago. And fantastic selection of pies. They even got cow pie. Well, that's the Salt and Pepper Museum, which unfortunately doesn't look like it's open, but it's a grand old building. And the Wetherspoons pub has got the best pitch in town. It's the most magnificent building. And it's the penny black. I shall have to go in and have a look and have a beer and research it. What a fantastic building. It's novel what they've done with the telephone box. Look, they've turned it into a garden, beautiful bedding plants display. So the interior of the penny black is somewhat different to the exterior, and you can see that it was a timber frame building, basic building really, hence the reason that they could literally jack them up if they went down due to subsidence. Two pints of beer for £4, how about that? Built as a post office. Purpose-built post office, and it's the town's largest liftable building. They used to build them so that they could be jacked up or even moved due to the subsidence that was so common in this area due to the salt works. Well, there's some flash barber's chairs. There's a hark back to the old days. On the side of this building, old adverts for tip cigarettes, and cigar merchant, Havana, Jamaican, British. There's the swing bridge from the road. It's the town swing bridge in Northwich. First road swing bridge on floating pontoons, and the first electrically operated swing bridge in Britain. Originally erected by the Weaver Navigation Trustees, 1899. The control bridge for the control hut for the swing bridge is just like a railway station signal box from the old days. So there's also a marina just past the first town swing bridge. You can see by the stanchions there how much this water level can rise. Visitor moorings across on the other bank. And the second swing bridge, just there. And it also has a modern precinct with ginormous coffee house. I see ginormous.